Web interface design. Dear student, this is the topic which you are having in your 5th unit, the web interface design. Under this topic, we are going to see some of the subtopic called drag and drop. Before getting the topic, I like to explain what is in the user interface. User interface is nothing but it acts as a medium between user and a computer hardware. And again, what's my user interface design? User interface design is nothing but how you are going to design an user interface. I have given the definition for user interface design. User interface design is a design of user interface for machines and software such as computer, home appliances, mobile and electronic devices. This is the definition for user interface. And again, the main goal of user interface design is nothing but you are going to design an UI or user interface as simple as possible, because the user interface should be very simple as possible. And again, there are 7 principles you need to be follow while designing an UI. I have listed all the 7 topics. And again, the first one is suitability for the task, which is nothing but if you are designing an UI for a banking software, it should be suitable for all the tasks. You need to include all the functionality which are required to banking applications. So that is known as suitable for task. And again, self-descriptive. Self-descriptive is nothing but the system should be explained to the user of their own. For example, if you are having an option called transaction, from the name itself, the user can identify this is the feature or this is the functionality which can perform transaction operations. And again, the third one is controllability. Controllability is nothing but your user interface should be designed in such a way that they can control their operations or their task. For example, if the user is willing to exit an operation, you need to give the functionality in their user interface. Likewise, the user should have complete control over the operation or functionality which you include in your user interface. And conformity with user expectation, which is nothing but you should be ensure while you are designing an user interface, you need to be ensure whether you have satisfied all the requirement and again the functionality which is user required. This is a very important thing, because as a developer, we need to satisfy the customer. So be a part of that. You need to be confirmed that whether you have included all the functionality or features and operation which are required for the particular task. And again, the 5th one is nothing but error tolerance, which is nothing but while you are designing an user interface, you should be ensure whether your product is reliable, because your product should be of reliable, then only the user can they trust. Because error tolerance is nothing but if a user may chance of giving a wrong input in some time, but your system should not be sudden termination. It should be respond to the user. For example, if a user may enter a wrong data, some of the web pages will display a prompt. It shows that user have entered a wrong data, so try to correct it. Likewise, you should be ensure that. And again, next is suitability for individualization, which is nothing but the individual person should be perform their needs of their own skill, no need of a support from others one. That is only suitability for individualization, which is nothing but if you are developing an UI for a banking application, the user should be of work on its own. He no need of depending on others to help to work on a mobile application. So that's why suitability for individualization. And again, the final most topic is suitability for learning. This is the last one for suitability of learning, which is nothing but it guides the user to learn the user system. It guides the user to learn the system, how you are going to use the system. This is the 7 principle you need to be followed while designing an user interface. And again, next is usability. The concept of usability is standardly defined in ISO 9241. The usability measures whether overall goals are achieved. That's why the usability shows whether the overall goals are achieved or not. It shows. And again, there are 7 presentation attributes which you need to be following while you are designing the user interface, which is nothing but clarity, discriminability, conciseness, consistency, detectability, legibility, and comprehensibility. These are the 7 things you need to be following while designing your UI. First one, clarity. What is meant by clarity? Which is nothing but while designing an UI, the information should be quick and accurate manner. For example, if you are having an operation called transaction, now you will be giving a menu called transaction, so that user can by clicking the menu he can perform all the transaction operations. So it should be quick and clearly defined. And discriminability is nothing but display the information can be distinguished accurately. For example, if you are having one or two menus, now you should be differentiate among them. For example, in transaction itself, you will be having different transactions. For example, within the bank or between the bank. So that in the menus, you will be defining whether you need to perform a transaction within the bank or between the banks. So that is known as discriminability. And again, conciseness. Conciseness is nothing but user are not loaded with the unwanted information, because the information only given to the user should be what they needed. You no need of giving some unwanted or overloaded information. That should be known as the conciseness. And consistency is nothing but a unique design you should be ensured. The unique design you should be ensured for the user expectation. What is the user expectation should be? You should be ensured with the unique design. And detectability. Detectability is nothing but you should direct towards the information required. For example, if you are willing to perform a transaction operation, there should be some direction. For example, initially you will be logging into the mobile application. Next, after entering into the login, if you are successfully logging, it will be showing some options will be there. Under that option, you will be choosing a transaction. Again, under transaction, you will be giving within the bank or between two banks. Again, you will be giving some PIN number to ensure the transactions. So likewise, it shows the direction from which to, after login, where you need to go, after login, after transaction, where which option you should go. The direction is known as the detectability. And legibility is nothing but information should be easy to read. And again, if you are giving some menus now, it should be easy to read, and again, it should be easy to understand. You should not use the difficult jargons to make confuse the users. Okay, it should be very easy, and the words should be very easy to understand the users. And comprehensibility, which is nothing but understand and recognize the meanings. Okay, if you are giving some options now, it should be understandable. It should not be so difficult levels. And these are the 7 presentation attributes you need to be follow while designing the user interface. And next, user guidelines. This is the most important thing you need to have for an UI interface, which is nothing but, for example, if you are purchasing a physical product, for example, assume if you are purchasing a mobile phone, they will be giving a user manual, which is nothing but in the form of a book. It will be enclosed, it will be placed inside your mobile phones and all, so that by reading the book, you can understand what are the functionality and features which your mobile phone or physical device hold. In case of softwares, it is not possible to hold given a user manual like that. So that we are having some of the guidelines which we given for a software product. I have listed some of them. First one is prompt. Prompt is nothing but a small dialogue screen displayed in your web page. It will give some set of information to the users. Okay. For example, assume a user may have typed a improper data in a text field. Automatically, a dialogue box, a prompt box will be displayed and shows that you have typed a mismatch input or mismatch data in your field. So likewise, the prompt is mainly a small dialog box that shows the users you have make some mismatch operations. Okay, the main advantage or the main usage of prompt is nothing but to guide the user that you have make a wrong data or not. Okay, and second is status information. The status information is nothing but assume you are trying to fill an online application. If you are performing an online application, you can perform the different stages. The first stage, you will be sign-upping an account. After sign-upping the account, you will be fill-upping an application. After fill-upping the application, you will be move for payment. If your payment has successful, you will be print out the application. These are the 4 stages which is most commonly followed in all the applications. For example, if I were in this stage 2, for example, I am filling the application. In the top, there will be a bar called status information bar. It shows that in which stage I am where. For example, if I have successfully completed the application form filling, it will be automatically moved to the next stage, which is nothing but the payment, where I can perform some of the payment operation. So that no need of by the user, by seeing the status information itself, he can understand which stage he is now in current situation, so that regarding with that he can perform the operations. Okay, that's the need of status information. And again, third one is error management. This is the most important thing, because the user may know about anything, may not know about the product which he is using. So sometimes he may enter a wrong data, na the error message or error correction should be done. Okay, that is known as error management. These are the three most properly used user guidelines. First one is prompt, which is nothing but a small dialog box which is displayed on your screen that shows that you will be performing, you need to perform this kind of operation, or some guidelines will be given to the user. Second is status information. Status information is nothing but in which status information is nothing but in which status you are, in which stage or which perform it will be shown. And again, error management. Error management is nothing but it will be displayed the error messages relevant to the your operations. And again, introduction. If you see, the drag and drop option is one of the functionality which we were seeing in lot of operations. And the history of drag and drop is in 1984, the Macintosh operating system is the first operating system which they have included the drag and drop. If you take the user interface functionalities, now almost the every functionality has been firstly introduced in Macintosh. By seeing the Macintosh only, all of them are copying their functionality from the Macintosh. Oh, that's the first point. Okay, in 1984, the Macintosh is an operating system which they have first introduce the drag and drop option. And again, what the main advantage of drag and drop is easy way to move, copy, delete the file on your user desktop. This is the main advantages, or this is the most important functionality you can say about drag and drop. And again, in 2000, a small startup called Halfbrain, this is the first company they have launched in a web-based presentation. For example, this is the first company. Initially, the Macintosh or the Apple company have been introduced the drag and drop option in an operating system. And again, Halfbrain have been introduced this functionality in a web-based presentation. That's the first company. And again, they have written the complete page in a programming language called DHTML. This is the introduction of drag and drop. And again, for example, I have given an example for drag and drop in a page load. Okay, for example, sometimes if you are closing a web page, suddenly a prompt will be displayed and shows that whether you are willing to leave the web page or not. Likewise, there will be a question will be asked. If you are willing to leave, now we can press the button called leave. That kind of options are come under the menu called drag and drop. Okay, and again, actors are nothing but if you are taking about drag and drops, na, there are different type of cursors you can be used under drag and drop. Okay, first one is cursor, and again the second one is tool tip, and third one is drag target. Okay, these are the three different tools, or we are saying as actors, which we can use under drag and drop menus. And again, the final thing, the drag and drop list. Okay, actually the drag and drop list are nowadays using in our mobile phone itself. Okay, it is nothing but it is similar to rearrange the module, which is nothing but, for example, assume if you are taking any Android mobile phones, your icons will be arranged in any formats from row and column wise. It will be arranged. If you are willing to move one icon from one location to other location, now what are the step we need to do? We will be long pressing the icon, and again it will be selected, and again we will be moving to the location which we needed. Okay, likewise the drag and drop will be used. The example I have given, the same thing, the mobile phone, which is nothing but the icon can be moved from one place to other. Okay, this is the latest feature, the drag and drop options which we are using in our mobile phones. Okay, that's all about the topics of a drag and drop, and thank you for your listenings. Okay, thank you.